Hi everyone, welcome to the RPB Resonance Chemistry. Now we are discussing another important lecture on Nagashi cross coupling reaction. Here it is also the new CC single bond formation palladium catalyzed reaction. Okay, so general definition of Nagashi cross coupling reaction is palladium catalyzed cross coupling of alkynyl aryl and alkynyl halides. Alkynyl aryl and alkynyl halides with unsaturated organozinc reagents provides a versatile method to preparing the stereo-defined aryl alkynes. Okay, here it is the aryl alkynes as well as like aryl alkenes, alkynes, conjugated dienes, conjugated enines, so in the presence of a palladium catalyst. Nowadays, so the advanced synthesis, not only palladium, so here we used the nickel also catalyzed reactions, palladium or nickel catalyzed. This is the modification of a Nagashi coupling. Okay, palladium or nickel catalyzed cross coupling of alkyl halides, simple halides reacted with zinc reagent, organo zinc reagent, then it forms the new CC single bond, then it is called Nagashi cross coupling. Now the general representation of reagents like this, Rx treated with R dash zinc halide, okay, in presence of palladium complexes, now here it creates the R dash again along with the elimination of Z and X, X dash. This is the X dash. Okay, now here R is equal to any alkene group or alkynyl or alkynyl. Okay, or R is equal to aryl. Now R dash is equal to unsaturated compounds. E9s means it may be alkenes or alkynes or aryls, such type of groups, or aryls, benzoyls, any unsaturated compounds are favors the Nagashi coupling reaction, So this is the basic introduction regarding to the Nagashi coupling. Here it is the best method to prepare the R2R, that is a new CC single bond formation, Okay, now he is also one of the Nobel awardee scientists. He got the Nobel Prize in 2010 regarding to their palladium catalyzed reaction, cross coupling reaction of a palladium catalyzed. Okay, now here in this case also halides reactivity order like this: iodine greater than triflate iodine, OTF greater than bromine greater than chlorine greater than fluorine. So whenever here the fluorine and bromine is present, we will go through the bromine only. Okay, so chlorine and bromine presents bromine only. Now here iodine and bromine, then iodine readily replaces their group with R dash of zinc compound, Okay, this is the basic introduction. Now let us discuss some of the catalytical loops of Nagashi coupling. Now the catalytical mechanical pathway of the Nagashi coupling is like this. So now here it is palladium Ln, that means tetra-coordinated, here L4. So whenever the ligand dissociation takes place, the two moles of ligands are dissociated. Now it becomes palladium L2. So then after the addition of alkyl halide group, so then it becomes palladium LL. Here it is R and X. So in this case, here oxidation state is 0. Now in this case, oxidation state is 2. So palladium oxidation state increased by 2 units, then it is called oxidative addition. In first step, here it undergoes the oxidative addition. So in the second step, they will undergoes the cis-2 trans isomerization. So in this case, here these R and X groups are oriented trans to each other. Here cis groups, then it becomes a trans, then it is called cis to trans isomerization. So now here L. Okay, then after we will use the our reagent, that is R dash zinc halide. So organo zinc reagent. So here R dash, here the R dash from zinc metal, which is transferred from zinc to palladium, then it is called transmetallation reaction. Okay, now here R dash will shift switch to the palladium metal. Now here it is R dash, here it is R ligand, ligand. Here the it is eliminated like this. Zn X X dash. Let us assume it is X dash. Okay. Now here it is eliminated. So now again in this case, here it undergoes, in this case, here it undergoes cis2 trans isomerization. Now here trans to cis isomerization. Whenever the reductive elimination it favors this cis compound, that's when here trans to cis isomerization takes place. So generally each and every catalytical loops follows this type of cis to trans isomerization. Now here I will explain. So palladium R R dash ligand ligand. Palladium R R dash ligand ligand. Now here it undergoes like a reductive elimination. It gives R to R dash. It gives R to R dash. Now again our catalyst is regenerated. Our catalyst is regenerated. So finally, whenever our solvent molecules, like if I will take the palladium PPH3, if I taken four times, now I would like to add the PPH3Xs, then it becomes again as usual the palladium L4 complex. Palladium L4 complex. This is the simplest catalytical loops regarding to the Nagashi coupling. Now here it is A, it is B, C, D, E. It involves five steps. So one is oxidative addition. Oxidative addition. In this case here the oxidation state as well as coordination number increased by 2 units. Now the second step, here it is a cis2 trans isomerization. Cis2 trans isomerization due to the speed up of the transmetallation step. Now the cis, C is the transmetallation. Transmetallation. Okay, now the next one is like D, fourth step. Here it is again trans to cis isomerization. Trans to cis isomerization. Now the final step is reductive elimination. Final step is reductive elimination. So these five steps are involved in the Nagashi cross coupling reaction. Finally, we will get the RR, that is a new CC single bond reaction from the alkyl halides, again organo zinc reagents with the help of a palladium catalyst. So not only palladium, we use the palladium or nickel. So this is the modification of Nagashi coupling. Now let us discuss this, some of the problems regarding to the Nagashi cross coupling reaction. Now let us look at the problems on Nagashi cross coupling reaction. So in generally, Nagashi means organo zinc reagent treated with alkynyl or alkyl or aryl or whatever the ligand, whatever the organic triplet, that is electrophiles, organic like alkyl halides or alkynyl halides, aromatic halides, whatever the group are. Now here it gives the palladium PPH3 four times or nickel nickel catalyst will give up their corresponding new CC single bond formation product. Now let us assume, so this is the like R group, R dash group, R dash ZnCl. So these all these group considered as Ri. Okay, so generally Ri treated with R dash ZnCl, it will give up R to R dash, the remaining ZnCl iodine is byproduct. So in this case, now here it is the R dash, R. So here R having the like a trans stereochemistry. Now here it is the one on one priority, that is a trans stereochemistry. So now in this products it retains the trans isomerization, that means trans stereochemistry. Trans stereochemistry. So here it is the 1 2 3. So 1 2 3. Okay, now here it creates their group. This is the product. This is the product with retention of the configuration. Now here it is the new CC single bond. New CC single bond formation between the organo zinc versus organo zinc and alkyl halide or alkynyl halide. Alkyl or alkynyl halide. This is the simplest product of Nagashi cross coupling reaction. Nagashi cross coupling reaction. Now let us discuss the second problem. So that is similarly here alkynyl, here also alkynyl halide which is treated with organo zinc reagent, that is aryl zinc reagent. Now it is also, it retains their stereochemistry, phenyl ethyl phenyl. It is the bromide. It is the bromide, however, which is treated with our corresponding zinc reagent, that is benzene. Okay, now here O methyl, here it is the ZnCl. Okay, these two are eliminated through the consecutive steps of like oxidative addition, cis trans isomerization, transmetallation, followed by the trans cis isomerization, finally reductive elimination. It gives up new CC single bond, new CC single bond. This is the product regarding to the second one. Now the third one, similarly, so here it gives up their product. So here it is methyl, here it is a benzene group, NO2, benzene group. And O2. So para nitro compound, para nitro bromo benzene. So now here it gives up their new CC biaryl compound. Here also one of the advantage method, biaryls preparation, that is biphenyls preparation. Biaryls or biphenyls preparation. So this is the third example regarding to the our example, our negation coupling. Now let us discuss fourth example. So very easier, pretty easier. Now here ZnBr. So which is replaced by the iodine. So there is no complication. So here it having the more than one leaving groups like iodate, bromides are there. Now here it requires like a certain regio chemo selectivity. There is no need for the selectivity. Directly it gives up their corresponding products. So here it is a nitrobenzene. So now here it forms again biaryl compounds. Biaryl compounds, it tolerates cyanides, esters, carbonyl functionals also. Now here it is the cyclopropyl zinc bromide which is treated with like phenyl iodide. Now it gives either these type of product, cyclopropyl benzene. These are the simple example. Now let us discuss some of the other examples also. These are the some other examples of negation coupling. Now here similarly, so here it is a primary alkyl organo zinc reagent, primary organo zinc reagent. Now here vinyl zinc reagent, here also vinyl zinc reagents. Okay, now first problem is phenyl C double bond O, like these type of groups. Here it creates the new CC single bond with a like alkynyl compound of alkynyl halides. This is the first product. Now in the second case, the same manner, now we will get the product like this phenyl compound. Okay, now here it creates the double bond with the compounds, very easier. So this is the product of right side, that is a triflate compound. This is the like a organo zinc compound. Here it creates the new CC single bond, that is called, that is our negation coupling product, here it is. So and another important thing in this reaction, so now here it is palladium catalyst, here also palladium catalyst. So in previous case also palladium catalyst, now but in this case we use the nickel catalyst, nickel ACS taken twice. So nickel can catalyze the like organo zinc as well as alkyl halide reactions, not only alkyl halides also it gives their new CC single bond products, it may be possible product, now here it creates the new CC single bond, 1, 2, 3, 4. That means four compounds, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now again it give up their product. Now here O, C double bond O, tertiary butyl, that is the product, regarding to the nickel catalyzed negation cross coupling, Now in this ninth case, so here give up their E9s, so double bond, here it is a triple bond, C4H9. So this is the like the E9, NC5H11. This is ene, this is ine. Simply it is called as E9 compounds. Now the final example, here it is the like isoquinoline derivative of zinc bromide, which is reacted with like our aryl halide. It gives the new CC single bond formation product, Here it is the like benzene ring, that is a COO ethyl. These are the very simple examples regarding to the negation cross coupling reaction. If it is possible, I'll explain the another lecture on negation cross coupling reactions, which are prepared like organo aluminates, organo zirconiums, organo boranes. Okay, such type of reagents can also give their alkynyl alkynyl halides. Again, they are giving the like enines, conjugated dienes, such a type of complexes also. That's why, if it is possible, I will make the another video on Nagashi, modified Nagashi coupling reactions. Okay, until this is the Nagashi coupling reactions. Thank you for watching.